Is everything okay?
No. Bradley's dead.
What? Did he choke too?
I'm on duty.
Chef, will you quit that? Your name's not Michelle. It's Michael. And you grew up in Jersey.
Not in front of the clients. Okay, how did Bradley die anyway?
Someone hit him over the head with a wrench.
In the hallway? With a wrench? Seriously?
But who did it? Scott says he was outside, but we didn't see him.
And I saw Scott and Emily arguing earlier, but when I questioned
him... He acted really strange.
Yeah. Scott, why were you outside just now?
I was calling the police.
What? I thought you called them 20 minutes ago.
So you really weren't outside?
No. I mean, yes, I was outside, but I didn't call the police before.
What? Why not?
I needed time to think.
About what? How you murdered Mrs. Wagner?
No, not murder. Jeez.
Scott, what happened?
Okay, I'm sorry. I only meant to make her sick. I didn't mean to kill her.
What exactly did you do to her?
And what were you arguing about?
Chels, I've been lying to you about my past. It's too embarrassing. The reason my family's not here tonight is because I didn't invite them. I don't come from an upper-class family like yours. My folks run a gas station in Iowa. I was planning to tell you, just not tonight. Then I ran into Emily. She found out about my past and threatened to tell you everything.
What did you do?
I panicked. I took a glass of champagne and went to the bathroom and spiked it with 4 Tylenol PM. I waited for Emily to finish talking to the wedding planner and offered her the drink. I thought she'd pass out for the night, not die.
So that's why you're acting so strange in the lounge.
Chels, I poisoned Emily. Mr. Wagner, I'm so sorry.
You didn't kill her. 4 Tylenol PM won't kill anyone.
It's true! Once, I accidentally took 6 because I thought they were candy.
Oh, and then quiet! The adults are talking.
So if the groom is off the hook...
Off the hook? He drugged the woman?
But he didn't kill her.
But something did. The appetizers?
That doesn't explain Bradley.
Well, Mrs. Wagner and Bradley were arguing in the hallway. Something was going on between them. Maybe an affair?
Certainly not.
Pardon, Monsieur Wagner. Forgive my silver, Peter.
For the last time, will you drop the accent?
How does this relate to Derek?
Maybe he was also sleeping with Emily.
Oh, please. I wouldn't put it past him.
Derek confronted Audrey about something. Sorry, Audrey.
Okay, look, I didn't do anything. All right, that guy Derek hit on me at a club this summer, but I didn't talk to him then, and I didn't talk to him tonight.
Quiet!
I've heard enough. You know, the food and drink was safe when it left the kitchen. I tested it myself. It's part of my job, sir, your best interest. It's also part of my job to be aware of Mrs. Wagner's activities. And yes, she and Bradley were well acquainted. They used to date, but I assure you, there was nothing going on now. During my sweep of the grounds, I found rat poison in the janitor's closet. This likely killed the first two victims and was probably concealed in the appetizers.
What about Bradley? He wasn't poisoned.
I'm getting there. The wretch that killed Bradley was also from the janitor's closet, convincing me there's only one murderer.
I still think it was Scott. He was in the hallway when Bradley was killed.
I don't think so. There was someone else there, on her way to get you from the car. Scott just told us Miss Wagner was talking to that same person right before he slipped her the cold medicine.
So? We were friends.
Well then. Ladies, empty your purses. Gentlemen, pull out your pockets. I think a poison quiche or two will appear.
This doesn't prove anything. I was saving it for later.
Oh my gosh, I remember you taking that from my tray.
But why? I mean, what did you have against either of them?
Emily promised me this wedding, and then she tries to stop it? She always screwed me over. So I took those quiche, and I found the poison, and I caught up with her after she talked to Bradley.
But what about Derek?
We slept together.
Oops.
And Bradley? What about him?
I didn't like his cologne.
Come on. You have the right to remain silent.
Well, someone came out of his shell tonight. You okay, Dan?
Oh, yes. I'll be fine.
I'm sorry for everything.
You know, I've never been to Iowa. Maybe we should visit your parents.
I'd like that.
Have you even been to France?